This is Lucy. Lucy doesn't have a left forearm. She was born that way. Normally, if Lucy wanted to get a prosthetic arm, it would cost thousands of dollars. That's a lot of money for something she'll outgrow in a year. See this bucket of purple goop? Lucy is about to stick her arm in there to get fitted for a new prosthetic device. But this one won't cost her parents thousands of dollars. In fact, they don't even need to buy it. No one does. All they have to do is print it. I'm Daisy Rosario. I'm on a mission to find tomorrow. But today, my journey leads me to a scout retreat. Here in Maryland, an unlikely group of boys and girls are helping make affordable prosthetic devices a reality.
So what are you getting ready to do?
Right now we're just getting the printer ready to start a print.
This is Sarah, one of these renegade scouts. And right now she's showing me how to use a 3D printer.
Okay, and it's saying it'll finish in about 20 minutes.
Oh, there it goes.
And this is Connor. He's a senior patrol leader.
All right, guys, how many of you have seen these before or something like them? Whoa, okay, a lot of you guys. So can I hear what they are? Yeah.
They are prosthetic hands.
What was that? From a 3D printer, absolutely.
This is a youth-run retreat, so the scout leaders can essentially talk about whatever they want.
Everybody go like this.
Today, they're talking about how to print hands for kids like Lucy. And while interest amongst the scouts is quickly growing, they can't possibly keep up with the demand themselves. Every year, roughly 1,000 babies are born missing all or part of a limb in the U.S. alone. These scouts are part of a worldwide network of volunteers, with help coming in from youth groups, schools, makerspaces, and basement laboratories. And if you ask any of those people who's behind this global operation, they'll all point to a research scientist at RIT named John Shull.
How did you find your way to this?
You know, about 26 months ago, instead of preparing a class, I was looking at videos on YouTube. I came across one about a South African carpenter who had a shop accident and accidentally cut the fingers off one hand and was told that partial hand prosthetics are really expensive and hard to come by. He went to Google and he found his way to Ivan Owen, a puppet maker and prop maker in Washington State, who had made a great big mechanical hand controlled by fingers as a great big puppet for a movie scene. And together they worked for over a year designing this hand, and he explained that they had eventually come upon a way of 3D printing this device, that they had eventually come to recognize that this device could be helpful not just for people who had fingers chopped off in a wood shop, but, for example, for people born missing fingers and hands. And he mentioned that he was putting the design online. YouTube video comments are typically the most demoralizing literary genre in the history of mankind. In this case, there were a number of people who said, this is really great what this guy is doing. I would do that. And so I called their bluff.
John created a simple map and left a YouTube comment of his own. Volunteers with 3D printers quickly started to show up. And not just a couple, a lot. So now, if someone like Lucy needs a hand, her family can check John's map and find someone near them who can make it. In other words,
it worked.
Try to swim with it? All right.
What started with John's map has snowballed to become a worldwide network called e-Nable. While medical-grade prosthetics can cost many thousands of dollars, the e-Nable network makes arms for about $45 worth of materials and delivers them to children in need at no cost. These devices are completely mechanical, using movement from the recipient's existing limbs to allow them to grasp objects. It's not a perfect solution, but e-Nable is constantly refining it.
Lucy, I think this is the one you had at home, right? You're interested in showing us what you can do with it?
Lucy has been working with John for over a year now to help develop a new model of 3D printed arm for the e-Nable network.
And did that come out? Let's see, what'd you do?
Came out.
It came out.
No.
That's okay.
I was pushing it in.
You're right. Okay, so that's, there you go, you did it. That's something we can fix. We'll call that the Lucy bolt. Okay, we'll work on that.
Currently, e-Nable can produce and iterate on its devices without government restriction. But even if that doesn't last forever, momentum is on John's side.
Our real mission is just to get these innovations into the hands of everyone who needs them every which way we can while we're in this window of opportunity.
So far, e-Nable has delivered hands in 37 countries and recently received a $600,000 grant from Google.org. e-Nable plans to reduce production costs from $45 to $25 and give away 6,000 prosthetics in the next 2 years. but John thinks hands and arms are just the beginning.
This general internet collaboration scheme is almost certainly going to lead to participatory medicine, advances in nutrition and pharmaceuticals. I think it really means that there's a new era of crowd science and technology that is really going to change things in a very exciting and democratizing way.
So what started as a YouTube comment turned into one of the most inspiring philanthropic efforts of the 21st century. And if that's possible, well, why stop there?
What would you like to see next? Is there anything else you'd like to be able to do?
A cartwheel and I want one that shoots out candy.